Hey, I'm Manuela with Plytix. In this video, I'll explain how to create an import feed. Import feeds allow you to automatically fetch data from a feed on a set schedule to import into Plytix. This is especially useful when you're updating prices regularly, want to automate the retrieval of information from a different system like an ERP, want to get incoming data from your suppliers into your Plytix account, or when you need daily stock updates, and so on. First, make sure you have this feature enabled. If you need import feeds in your account, you can reach out to your customer success manager by chat or email. To create an import feed, first click on products and choose imports from the dropdown. This will take you to the imports area. From the left side menu, choose feeds. When you're creating your first import feed, the import feed overview will look like this. Once you begin creating feeds, they'll be listed here and you'll be able to manage them. But before I show you what this looks like, let's add our first feed. When you click add feed, a pop-up will appear. Here you'll name your feed and choose where you're fetching the information from. Feeds require a link that points to a CSV. These can be fetched from a public file URL, an FTP or SFTP server, or a Dropbox account. When fetching from a public file, enter the URL here. If you're not sure how to generate this URL, ask your customer success manager and they'll try to help you out as best as they can. When fetching from an FTP, an SFTP, or a Dropbox connection, choose the connection that you want to use from the dropdown here and enter the file path here. When defining the file path, only include the last folder name and the CSV name. If you need help setting up an FTP, an SFTP, and a Dropbox connection, you can check out the video that I'm linking here that explains how to do so. Next, you're able to set the import schedule, which refers to how often you want Plytix to fetch information from these sources. Once you're happy with the feed settings, click Next. Now you'll define your file settings, the import settings, and match your CSV columns to attributes in Plytix. These are the same steps as when you're matching columns in our CSV importer. If you're not sure how to do this, then click on the video that I've linked both up here and in the description to see how to set up your import settings. If you already know how to do this, then you can pause this video now to match your attributes. And when you're finished, come back and I'll show you how to manage your import feeds. Okay, so once you're finished with the matching settings, you'll notice that for feeds, instead of start import, it'll say save import settings. This will take you back to the import feeds overview. Now, and this is really important, once you've mapped your import feeds, you should not add or remove columns to the original file. This is because the columns are already mapped, so adding and removing columns will confuse the system and lead to an import error. All right, now back to the feeds overview. Up here, it'll tell you how many feeds are available in your account and how many you've already created. This table shows a list of all of your import feeds. The columns show you the feed's name, the last time it was processed. This means the last time that Plytix fetched information from the source, the import schedule you've set. If you hover over this, you'll see the time zone that it's scheduled for, the date and user stamp for when this feed was created and the last time that it was modified, and whether the import feed is active or not. You can click on the toggle to turn it on and off, and an active feed will process automatically, whereas an inactive feed will not. Hovering over the feeds row will also make two new options appear. This one, which lets you process the feed manually, and this one, which lets you delete the feed. You can also delete feeds in bulk. To edit an import feed, click on the feed's name, which will open the feed's details page. Now, before you make any changes, make sure that the feed is inactive. Once the feed is inactive, you can change the scheduling as well as edit the feed attribute matching. I hope you found this video tutorial helpful. If you have any questions whatsoever, don't hesitate to reach out to us. If you're a Plytix user, you can email your customer success manager or you can reach us by chat at plytix.com.